Hey everybody, Dominic here. And in some previous videos, I have talked about utilizing Google G Suite when sharing content with your students in Canvas. And in this video, I want to show you a shortcut for sharing content with your students that I think is going to save you a lot of time and also ensure that your students can access all of the content that you want them to. So, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hop over to my Google Drive. Okay, so here I am in my Google Drive. And a while back, I had created this folder in my My Drive called Canvas Content. And the purpose of this folder was for me to put all of the different documents and materials that I was planning to share with my students. Now, if I go into that folder, you can see I've got different subfolders and files in here. Now, here's what I want to point out is that this folder itself has been shared. Okay, so if I were to go back to my My Drive and right click on this folder, Canvas Content, if I go to Share, you'll see that currently this folder is set so that anyone with the link can view. Okay, now I set the share permissions for this folder just like I would for any file in Google Drive. Right click, click share, and then I clicked get shareable link, and I clicked the drop down. And what I did is I went to more and I chose the second option from the top so that anyone with the link. And then down here, I chose can view. Okay, and I hit save. Anyone with the link can view. Now, here's the deal. Right here is the link to that folder. And I could, if I wanted to, copy that link and paste it into my Canvas course. And what that would do is that students who clicked on that link would see everything within that folder. And have view permissions to everything in that folder. And that might be good. But that's not really the reason that I did this. I don't really want to share that parent folder out to my students. Instead, what I want to do, I want to share out individual files that are within that folder with my students. Okay? So why did I share this parent folder? If I want to share out the individual files, the reason is because in Google Drive, if you set share permissions for a parent folder, all of the folders and files that are within that folder are going to adopt those share permissions. Okay, let me demonstrate what I mean. Okay, so first of all, remember in this Canvas content folder in my My Drive, I've set it so that anyone with a link can view, right? So I'll hit done on that. I'm going to go inside that folder and I'm going to make a new Google Doc. So I'm going to click on New and I'll click Google Doc. Now notice it prompts me with a message. It says, hey, create in a shared folder. The created item will have the same sharing permissions as the selected folder. And it says, do you want to create and share? Okay, this is the time-saving feature that I wanted to point out to you. When I put files into this shared folder, those files are going to get the same share permissions. So if I create this new Google Doc, okay, and I will give this Google Doc a name, I will go with one of my tried and true demonstration Google Doc names. I'm going to call it Awesome Doc. Okay. Now it's got its name saved. Now, if I go up to share in the top right, look, it says anyone with a link can view this document. Well, it can access. If I go into share, we can see the details. Anyone with a link can view. So that share permission's been set up for me already without me doing anything. And that's because I created this document in a shared folder. Okay. And that's great. I don't want to have to take the time to set the share permissions for every single file that I want to share out in my course. I would rather just do it once, and from that point forward, all my documents by default will have that permission. Okay? If you have a folder structure with files already set up, you can still go to that parent folder, set that permission, and all the folders and files within will adopt that permission. Okay? Now, a few things I want to point out here. Number one, by default, files and folders will adopt the share permissions of the parent folder. However, you can change the share permissions of individual files and folders that are, you can make those permissions different from the parent folder. So if I make Awesome Doc, and right now it's got the anyone with the link can view, I could, if I wanted to, go up to share and go here for the shareable link and turn off the shareable link and hit done. Okay. It's still within that shared folder. It's still, you know, it hasn't gone anywhere, but I've just removed the share permission. Okay, so you can change it. It's just that by default, it's going to adopt whatever that parent folder has set for it. Okay, I'm going to quick change that back so I can do this. This is the same process I would go through. Okay, and I hate when that message gets in the way. There we go. Okay, save that. Okay, so that's one thing to keep in mind. You can change the permissions for individual files within a shared folder. Second thing I want to remind you of is that, remember, every file and every folder has its own unique link, okay? So this link up here is to AwesomeDoc. It is different from the link to the parent folder, okay? So remember, if you set up this shared parent folder structure, you're probably not going to share out the link to that parent folder. You're probably just going to share out the links to the individual files that you want students to see. So in this case, I would share out the link for AwesomeDoc into my Canvas course. I probably would not share out the link to the Canvas course content folder to my students. The last tip that I want to mention is what I've just shown you with setting the share permissions on folders is really, at the moment, something you can only do in your My Drive, okay? If you are using Team Drives, which, by the way, Team Drives are awesome if you are coordinating with a program or department or even in student groups within your class, Team Drives are great, but one drawback of Team Drives is that we can't set share permissions on entire folders. If I right-click this folder here in a Team Drive, notice the share permissions grayed out. And that's because in Team Drives, you can't actually set share permissions for whole folders. You could, if you wanted to, let me see if I got a good example here. Maybe I'll go into our FQAS folder here. I could, if I wanted to, select a bunch of these files by clicking one, holding down shift, clicking down here. Okay, so I selected a bunch of files. I could right click all of these files, go to share, and do get shareable link for all of them. And then all of them would get the same share permissions in one go. Again, remember, each one will have its own unique link. Okay, so you can do that if you want to set share permissions for a bunch of files in one go. But just remember, in Team Drives, you can't set the share permissions at the folder level. You have to select a file or a group of files and set share permissions that way. And I guess one last bonus tip is once you have set the share permissions for a group of files, be it with the parent folder structure in your My Drive or by selecting a bunch of files in the Team Drive, whichever way, going forward, if you want to get the shareable links to those files, you don't have to open the file to do that. All you have to do is just right-click it. So I'll right-click AwesomeDoc and get shareable link. And done. It copies it to the clipboard as soon as you do that. And again, I don't need to worry about going in and setting the permissions. They're already set for me. Okay. So that's just a little shortcut when it comes to setting the share permissions of your documents and folders. Hopefully that was helpful, and thank you for watching.